Good morning. Today, can study about next economist as Nutvixell. Nutvixell. He lived during 1851 to 1926. Vixell was the founder of Swedish School of Economic Thought. Founder of Swedish School of Economic Thought. Developed new theories concerning the rate of interest and price level. He developed new theories concerning the rate of interest and price level. His theory concerning the relationship between money rate of interest and general price level. He studied for about money rate of interest and general price level. He analyzed the role of interest in generating inflationary or deflationary movements. To analyze role of interest, he studied analyzed inflationary and deflationary changes. He discussed the role of government and central bank in promoting price stability. He recommended government is must to protect price stability, and central bank also needed to keep price stability in the country. And he developed saving investment approach to monetary phenomena. He developed saving investment approach to monetary. Monetary means money. His major ideas are theory of capital and interest. Vixell defined capital as a coherent mass of stored up labor and saved up land. He defined capital as a coherent mass of stored up labor and saved up land. Stored up labor means they are using their productivity to do any work. Saved up land means not using the productive purpose. Then he described interest as the marginal productivity of waiting. He defined interest as marginal productivity of waiting. Then he included time element. It's an important factor in theory of interest. He defined interest as the difference between marginal productivity of saved up labor and land and marginal productivity of currently used labor and land. Interest is the difference between marginal productivity of saved up labor. Those labor are not working now. And land not using. And marginal productivity of currently used labor and land. Those who are working now and use those land are using now. So interest is the difference between marginal productivity of saved up labor and land and marginal productivity of currently, presently using labor and land. Then he classified natural and money rate of interest. Natural rate of interest means normal rate of interest. Money rate of interest means market rate of interest. According to Vixell, natural rate of interest was determined by basic technological factors. It is equal to marginal productivity of capital. Natural rate of interest is equal to marginal productivity of capital. But the money rate of interest was rate actually charged in the money market at a particular moment of time. When we are taking debt from other persons, we should pay the interest. That is, that charges the money rate of interest. What is the rate of interest exist in the market? That is money rate of interest. He made use of this distinction between natural rate of interest and money rate of interest to explain fluctuation in saving and investment. He used the concept, he used this classification between natural rate of interest and money rate of interest to explain fluctuation, that is movements, changes in saving and investment. So the changes in saving and investment, he used the concept of natural rate of interest and money rate of interest. When natural rate of interest was above money rate, businessmen would make more profit. When natural rate of interest, that is productivity of labor and land, is higher than money rate of interest, businessmen make more profit by increasing their capital investment. Only when two rates of interest were equal, prices would be stable. If natural rate of interest equal to money rate of interest, then price level is equal to stable. He emphasized the role of government and central bank in promoting stability of the economy. So he strongly recommended government is must to keep price stability in the country. He suggested that wholesale prices could be stabilized by controlling interest rate. He suggested that wholesale prices could be stabilized by controlling interest rate. Then his next idea, monetary reform. He gave more importance to international paper standard rather than of coinage of gold. We also use the Indian economy also used gold standard to analyze the value of the money or price. So here Wigzell gave more importance to international paper standard rather than coinage of gold. So instead of gold standard, he used international paper standard to measure price level. Then next, competition. He realized the limitations of perfect competition in the retail market. He regarded every retailer as a partial monopolist. He studied the limitations of the perfect competition in the retail market. He regarded every retailer as a partial monopolist, half monopolist. Next, population. Regarding population, he advocated limitations of population not by Malthusian moral restraint but by resource to deliberate contraceptive method. He recommended to control population, but he has not accepted the Malthusian moral restraint. Instead of the Malthusian measures, he used contraceptive. He promoted contraceptive methods to control population growth. Next idea is taxation. Wigzell opposed regressive tax system but favored mild progressive income tax. What is progressive income tax? When our income increase, tax rate also increase in a nominal rate. Regressive means its opposite case. So he supported progressive income tax. Then next, welfare. Recommended welfare services, particularly in the case of education. So we can summarize the ideas of Wigzell. He lived during 1851 to 1926. He was the founder of Swedish school. He developed new theories in the case of rate of interest and price level. His theory concerning relationship between money rate of interest and general price level. He analyzed the role of interest by analyzing inflationary and deflationary movements. He developed saving investment approach to monetary phenomena. His major theories are theory of capital and interest. Capital is a coherent mass. It is the total of the stored up labor and saved up land. He described interest as the marginal productivity for waiting. He included time with regard to analyzing the interest. He defined interest as the difference between marginal productivity of saved up labor and land and marginal productivity of currently used labor and land. Then he classified natural rate of interest and money rate of interest. It is equal to natural rate of interest was determined by the marginal productivity of capital. Money rate of interest is the rate actually charged in the market. He made use of distinction between natural rate of interest and money rate of interest to explain fluctuations in the saving and the investment. When natural rate of interest was above the money rate of interest, businessman can make more profit. So if two rates are equal, price stability can keep. He suggested wholesale prices could be stabilized by controlling interest rate. Then he explained about monetary reforms. He accepted international paper standard to keep the purchasing power of the money. Then he explained about the competition and studied about the limitations of perfect competition. He states every retailer as a partial monopolist, and he supported population control, and he supported progressive taxation system, and he recommended welfare services, particularly in the field of education. Okay, thank you.